Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about overview of services which are offered in Azure. Okay, so Azure provides various services. Okay, they have hundreds of services integrated in Azure which we can make use of them. Okay, so I have made them, for our simplicity, I have made them into few different categories, and I will explain them what about those categories, and I will take one example for each category and I will give you a slight idea. Okay, so one is computing services, and then second is storage services, networking services, app hosting services, artificial intelligence services, IoT services, integrated services, security services. So these are the high level categorization which I did. Okay, so there are a few others also, these are mainly. Okay, so Azure provides various computing services. So if you want, what is compute service? So if you want one example, I can say virtual machines. Okay, using Azure you can create a virtual machine. Okay, and you can make use of that virtual machine. Okay, and you can do any activity on the machine. It's like a normal physical computer, it is similar like that. You will get a server and you can do whatever the activity you want to do. Okay, so that one thing we can say one of the compute service example. Okay, the next category is storage services. So Azure provide various storage services. Okay, so it will provide so many databases as services, or data warehouses, or data like storages. Okay, so databases or data warehouses, you might have known little bit enough idea. So data lake storage is something like this is for big data. Okay, so when you want to store the huge amount of data in file format or in TSV or CSV formats. Okay, so those kind of data, unstructured data, you can store in data lake storages. Okay, so this type of variety of services it will offer under storage category. And there are few others, okay, not only this, there are so many others also. I am taking few top level. Okay, and Azure provide the next category is networking services. So virtual networks you can create using under these services, or you can create load balancers, so many other stuff you can do it. App hosting services is another category. One of the example is app services. This is most common used service in Azure. So what is app services is, actually when you develop a code, you will be hosting that, you will be deploying that code on some server, right? On IIS or on Apache Tomcat. So there are so many web servers are available out there in market, right? So you will be deploying the code there and you will be running the application from there, right? So you no need to have the physical server and have the IIS or Apache Tomcat deployed on the server. Okay, you can make use of these app services. You can just focus on developing code and you can deploy your code to app services. That's it. You will get a URL from there, and using that URL you can access your application what you developed. So app services are to host the applications actually. Okay, then IIT services, under this category there are so many machine learning suits or packages are available actually. You can make use of them. And IoT services, okay, and the next major category is integration services. Okay, so I will say the best example is Azure Data Factory. Okay, so when you say integration services, actually you might be knowing about SSIS, SQL Server Integration Services, right? What SSIS is actually do is it will take data from so many sources, and it will do some kind of transformation on the data. Okay, and then it will publish that data into some other source, okay, some other destination service. So this kind of data movement and data transformation and data architecture, this kind of pipeline creations, we can do it in SSIS side. So think like Azure Data Factory is similar to that. Using Azure Data Factory, you can connect variety of data sources and you can read data from them, and you can perform the step-by-step transformation of the data, whatever the manner you want, and then you can publish that particular transformed data into some destination source. So you can do all this kind of pipeline creations using Azure Data Factory. So that is why I am saying integrated services. So it will integrate various data sources and it will allow you the data transformation and data movement. Okay, then security services category. Under this I can say Azure monitoring services or Azure Active Directory services. Okay, these are very high used Azure services. Okay, you can create your own identities and you can manage your security principles there. So under Azure Active Directory category, and Azure monitoring services, actually what you can do is whatever the service you created, for example, I created one Azure Data Factory service, right? Okay, let's say, so using Azure monitor, what you can do, you can create a alert system mechanism on top of this particular service. So now, so that means once you create your Azure Data Factory, you can configure Azure monitoring for any alerts, whether my data factory is running good or whether there are any failures. So all those kind of monitoring it will do, not only on ADF, whatever the service you create in Azure, on top of all of those services, you can configure Azure monitoring services for your alerting mechanism, basically to monitor that, how it works, to check the health of the service actually. Okay, and the best part of the Azure is you have to only pay what you use. For example, if you create one service, if you created one service ADF, and you no need to pay for the ADF service from the moment you created it. Okay, you can only pay to the service till what time it ran, till what time it ran on the service. Okay, so for example, you have created ADF 1 year back, so till today it is taken 1 year, so you no need to pay for entire 1 year. Throughout the 1 year, you have ran ADF only for 2-3 months of the execution time, so you have to pay only for that particular time alone. So that is the best part in the Azure, you have to pay only for what you use. And another beauty about Azure services is they can grow elastically on demand. You can make them grow. Okay, for example, you have created a data lake storage, right? For example, let's assume you have ingested 1 terabyte of data. Okay, and after 10 to 15 days, you are going to ingest another 20 terabytes of data. It will grow automatically. Okay, so it has a beauty of the elastic. It can grow on demand. Okay, this is what all about high level services. Okay, offered in Azure. What I will do, I will create a separate playlist for each service. Okay, where you can learn how to make use of that service and what and all components offered inside that service. Those kind of things I will do it in a separate video series. Okay, so this series is basically to focus on basics on the Azure.